All right, in the previous video, I introduced the concept of molar solubility and solubility. And we are going to do a couple of problems where it looks like we're given the KSP and we have to calculate these values. And if we have time, I also have a bonus problem that I have prepared. Okay. Whoops. The first problem. Calculate the molar solubility and the solubility in grams per liter of SrCO3. Just as a reminder, solubility, the molar solubility, will be big S. And actually, I think in the text it's italicized. And then we have little s. Little s is the one that has this as the units, and molar solubility obviously has the units of molar. It's a molarity. Okay. Again, I get sort of lost and I don't know, a little bit worried if I don't see a reaction. There's my solid, and let me write out the chemical reaction. You know that carbonate is CO3 2 minus. So these are both charged, but there are no coefficients, so we're not going to square anything in our KSP expression. I also feel a lot better. It's like a security blanket if I write out the KSP expression. CO3 2 minus, and we do have a number for that. It's low, 1.6 times 10 to the minus 9. Okay, the idea of solubility, in particular molar solubility, is the amount of solid that does dissolve. So if, let's say, 10% of this dissolves, then that 10% becomes these two numbers, SR2 plus and CO3 2 minus. So if we say maybe, if we have, now I'm trying to figure out some numbers. If we have a 10 molar solution initially and 1 molar dissolves, right, the molar solubility is 1, and we would have 1 molar of each of these two. So do you see how the molar solubility, capital S, is actually the, can also be thought of as the concentration of your ions? So I'm going to substitute for S here and here. And obviously that is S squared equals 1.6 times 10 to the minus 9. And let me take the square root of that. I have on my calculator 1.6 times 10 to the minus 9 equals, and the square root of that number equals, let me get out of scientific notation, or let me get into scientific notation, and S is literally the answer to the molar solubility, 4.0 times 10 to the minus 5 molar. And literally, that's what it means. When we have this strontium carbonate and we dissolve it, well, your concentrations are going to be 4.0 times 10 to the minus 5 molar. That is the molar solubility. Oh, you know what that means? If you have 1 molar of this, this is how much of the ions we get. That makes a lot of sense. Okay. Now, your molar solubility, you know that molarity, big M, is the same as moles per liter. And for the solubility, little s, we need grams per liter. So let me just circle this to make sure that we know that that's one of the answers for the big S. For this one, we need the. Should have did this previously. We need the molar mass of SrCO3. Let me just find it real quick. Molar mass, SrCO3. The molar mass is 147.63 grams per mole. And take a look at how I would do my unit canceling. I take our molar solubility, 4.0 times 10 to the minus 5 moles per liter times, 147.63 grams per liter, grams per mole, grams per mole. And we cancel out moles. Okay, times 147.63 equals 5.9 times 10 to the minus 3 grams per liter. And that equals little s. Now, which number is more useful? Oh, this is useful because it literally tells you how much you should weigh on the scale and dissolve in a liter to get it to be just at saturation. What is this? Is this the same as 5.9 milligrams? Okay, so that's weighable on the balance. This one tells me that if I have 1 molar of strontium carbonate, then I should get this much molar of the ions, and I could scale up, right? Oh, wait, does it scale up? I take that back. I'm not going to say it scales up. But if I had 1 molar of that, then this is how much of the ions I would get. Let me double check my answer, and we could try another one. The other one is a little bit different. Let's see. Take a look at that while I double check my answer. Okay, good. And, yep, good. These two are good. Okay, now take a look at problem number two. Problem number two says that now we're working with this salt. What is that? That's silver chromate. And is this a huge difference? Well, here I'm not asking for the solubility, I'm just asking for the molar solubility. But look at the stoichiometry, look at the ratio of ions. For every 1 mole of chromate I make, I actually make 2 moles of silver. How is that going to change my KSP? How is that going to change when I start substituting S? Okay. I feel really good. I was afraid that this would be wrong. All right. So, let me number their steps actually. Step one, write the chemical reaction equation. Now, if you could do this without writing out the equation, that's great. Go ahead and do your exam without writing out the equation if they don't ask you explicitly. For me, I just get super nervous. I think I would forget a coefficient. I would forget an exponent. I would forget that we have twice as much silver now as we do for chromate. This doesn't look very focused. Give me 1 minute. That change. I'm just stalling for time. I'm not 100% sure how to deal with S in this case. Let me focus this. Come on. Oh, right there. Okay. Number two, KSP equals concentration of Ag plus squared times the concentration of CrO4 2 minus not squared. Number three, substitute for S. And substitute for KSP. 1.2 times 10 to the minus 12 equals. Now, what's the trick here? The trick here is to make S the concentration of the component that is 1 molar. It's not 1 molar. That has a coefficient of 1. 1 mole. Okay, so We have. Am I doing this right? Okay. So if this is S, the amount of this is S, the amount of AG has to be 2S. So I'm looking at the brackets actually. If the chromate concentration is S, the silver concentration has to be 2S. And now all of that is squared times S. It takes a little bit of practice, but it will become really fast eventually. Then we get 4S, and this is big S, right? Molar solubility. 4S squared times S equals 4S cubed equals that. Okay. How would I do this? If you don't need to show every step of your math, then what I would do is I would take 1.2 times 10 to the negative 12 and press equals. That number saved. And I gotta get S now. Divided by 4 equals. And then that's the cube root, but on my calculator, I would do 3, that symbol, answer, equals. My molar solubility is 6.69 times 10 to the negative 5, and it's a molarity. Go ahead and circle that. And I am satisfied with that answer as well. We have time for bonus round. You will pause the video once I show the problem, and then unpause it when you're done solving for this. Calculate the KSP for zinc phosphate if its solubility, little s, is 5.9 times 10 to the minus 5, important, grams per liter. Grams per liter. Solubility, molar solubility, is moles per liter. And then you could go backwards to get KSP. So we're working backwards. Go ahead and pause the video. Try your best. If you don't know the answer, at least put down some equations. I gave you the steps. Okay, 1, 2, and 3. But you'll have big S. We're given little s. You have to go backwards. You gotta get from little s to big S. I'll shut up. Come back. Pause it. Come back when you're done. Okay, you're back. So, just follow the steps and trust the steps. If the steps going in the forward direction doesn't help, then we'll just reevaluate and try another technique. But right now, I feel much more comfortable if I see the chemical equation reaction equation. Zinc is what? Zinc is 2 plus. Aqueous plus PO4, 3 minus aqueous, and we have two of those. Now, does that make sense? We have three zincs, that would be a plus 6. We have two phosphates, that would be a minus 6. Okay, good. That's a neutral salt. I gotta be careful. It's a salt that is neutral. Because now neutral salt has a new meaning, right? If you throw a salt into water, is the water acidic, basic, or neutral? Anyway, KSP. Oh my goodness, it's gonna be complicated. Zinc 2 plus cubed times phosphate 3 minus squared. 3. We don't know KSP. Okay. And we actually don't know big S, but we could get big S from little s. We just need to know what big S is or how it's used. How about this? 3s cubed. There's a 3. There's 3 there. And then if that's a 3, if that concentration is 3s, this concentration has to be 2s. And that is squared. This kind of looks familiar. 27, 3 times 3 times 3, s cubed. I'd be very happy if this is correct. Times 4s squared equals 27 times 4. This is 108s to the fifth. Okay. We are given little s. Little s equals 5.9 times 10 to the minus 5 grams per liter. Well, if I multiply that by something moles per gram, that looks like the inverse of the molar mass. Let's see. I'm not going to do this by hand. Let's see if I could find it on Google. Molar mass of, hopefully, zinc 3 parentheses PO4 and then subscript 2 or just 2. Okay, so when you do this, when you search on Google, just double check the formula that it's identical to what you have. I got, and grams goes on the bottom, 386.11 per, oops, per 1 mole. And that gives me, okay, 5.9 times 10 to the negative 5 equals, divided by 386.11. It's a lot of work. Hopefully it's right. Times 10 to the minus 7. The grams cancel out. So I do have moles per liter. And that does equal big S. Oh, good. I have that number saved. And I'm substituting it right there. That's big S also. And if I solve for that, I do solve for KSP. So that number, caret 5, very, very tiny, times 108. 108 equals. Huh. My KSP equals 9.00 times 10 to the minus 33. Very, very, very insoluble. Let me prove to you, yes. So this was a textbook problem, and I have the solutions manual, and 9.0 times 10 to the minus 33 right there. 9.0 times 10 to the minus 33, and that is for your zinc phosphate. Yeah, you might as well take a screenshot. Those are other ones that you can practice on. Those are your two answers. Great. That is all I want to discuss, really, for this unit and for this last topic of KSP solubility and molar solubility.